Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you very much for coming. I see many distinguished guests, many friends, very happy that you came. And thank you very much for to the organizers, all thanks for organizing this event, this working lunch. So we will debate on digitization and the defense of democracy. We had elections yesterday in Poland, so you can imagine that I have even an emotional attitude to this issue. And I'm very happy that my colleagues, members of the European Parliament, are here with us. I see Ivan Stefanec with us, Josian Kutayal, John Howard, Marina Kaljurand, she says I pronounce it well, Asita Kanko, whom have I missed, Malcolm Harbour, who chaired our Committee of Internal Market and Consumer Protection for a long time, our distinguished former member. I surely missed someone. Please excuse me. We have excellent... Bill Newton, done. Thank you very much. We have excellent speakers today. A special welcome to them. Mr. Trevor Davis, professor at the School of Media and Public Affairs of George Washington University and CEO of Counteraction. Mikko Salo, founder of Factor Bar, media innovator and EU advisor to LUT University. Marisa Jimenez-Martin, director and deputy for EU affairs in Facebook. And Paolo Cesarini, head of unit, media convergence and social media, DigiConnect, European Commission. Welcome to all of them and thank you for your coming. I will give you the floor for 7 minutes each, and then we will have a discussion. And why is it so important? We see in our everyday life that European democracies face a series of challenges, such as election interference, threats to media freedom, the use of disinformation campaigns, splitting of our societies through dissemination of fake news, hatred, etc. Ursula von der Leyen says that she wants a Europe to strive for more in nurturing, protecting, and strengthening our democracy. And she has announced a European Democracy Action Plan and announced a Digital Services Act and a co-regulatory framework on disinformation. She put a big stress on it when she spoke in the European Parliament. Digitization and constant technological evolution brought new challenges and opportunities for democracy. We all routinely take advantage of the thousands, many and benefits that the digitization offers to us in terms of services, information, entertainment, social engagement, etc., etc. But it has also effects that are disrupting. It has also disrupting effects on how we engage with one another. Online innovations have boosted boosted availability of news and boosted possibilities of dissemination of information of news. But millions of citizens are also confronted with false news, with unreliable or false information. We all encounter offensive and illegal content, including hate speech, threats online. While this type of content has always existed in the offline world, the speed and scale at which it spreads online can pose a new challenge, many new challenges, and a genuine threat to our democracy. We saw yesterday and months, years before, we saw in Poland how much disinformation, fake news, propaganda, and also spreading hate speech can influence democratic process. And it's not the only country in Europe where it happens. Today, we will discuss how different stakeholders evaluate the situation and with which concrete policies the European Union can contribute to safeguard democracy on our continent, in the EU. I am convinced that we came to the point when very concrete actions are needed to save our democracy. I hope that together we will work to find a way forward and that we will finally find the solution. Now, the time is very limited, so I will stop here and I will invite the speaker to take the floor. They will take the floor for 7 minutes, as I said, and the floor is to the speakers. I will first invite here Mr. Trevor Davis. Mr. Davis, the floor is yours. If you come here, it will be best. Thank you very much.